Welcome to our Proactive Studios. I'm Natalie Stoberman, joined by the CEO of Silex Systems, Michael Goldsworthy. Michael, thank you for joining us.
Thanks very much.
Now, there's been some big updates within the company, but before we dive in, let's give our investors an introduction into what Silex Systems is all about and how it specializes in uranium production and enrichment.
Sure. So Silex Systems is based in Sydney, Australia. And a couple of decades ago, we invented a laser-based technology for the enrichment of uranium, which is a vital step in making nuclear fuel, which the US has nearly 100 nuclear power reactors supplying about 20% of its electricity today. So it's a big market here in the US. Conventionally, enrichment is done with gas centrifuge, but we have the world's first laser-based technology, which is now being commercialized in a joint venture commercialization vehicle called Global Laser Enrichment, based in Wilmington, North Carolina. And that is a joint venture between Silex and Cameco Corporation, a very large uranium producer and nuclear fuel fabricator based in Canada. So we've been developing the technology and we're moving towards the key commercial demonstration at full commercial scale over the next 12 months or so. And there's been a lot of heightened interest in nuclear power given climate change and the recent events in Ukraine, which has seen quite a lot of potential for disruption in the nuclear fuel supply chain, because Russia has worked its way into the Western supply chain quite effectively. And today, the US depends on about 20% of its nuclear fuel coming from Russia, and the European Union about 30% of its nuclear fuel coming from Russia. So there's quite a bit of interest in how that's going to play out, given that sanctions on Russian nuclear fuel are being debated now in Washington and also in the European Union. So our technology has increased its profile recently as the next generation source of nuclear power fuel, and in particular uranium enrichment capability. So I hope that makes sense. It's not an easy concept to understand. It's high tech, but it's essentially all about providing a secure, reliable nuclear fuel supply chain once the sanctions on Russian fuel take effect.
Well, Michael, it definitely sounds like there's a sense of urgency to get that reliability when it comes to energy production. What kind of a timeline are we looking at this year for the project?
So we have about 12 months to go until we start commissioning what we call a pilot demonstration facility that will be in Wilmington, North Carolina, that's being built now. We just shipped the first commercial laser module from Sydney, where we built them and tested them. And that system arrived in Wilmington late last year and has been installed and is being prepared for operation. On the other hand, we do have some more work on the separator systems to go over the next few months, but we hope to be commissioning the full commercial scale pilot demonstration facility around this time next year. And then that will involve a few months of testing after that, at which point, if successful, then we can start focusing on our first commercial project, which is planned for Paducah, Kentucky, at a site where the first generation gas diffusion plant operated for many decades in Paducah by the Department of Energy. So it's very exciting times ahead. The milestones will involve getting the pilot system commissioned towards the end of this year, and then hopefully some news flow around the testing results into the first half of next year.
Mm-hmm. Quite the process ahead of you, but it seems like the company is off to a great start for 2023, joining a uranium ETF and also being named number 2 on the OTCQX Best 50 list. How does the company feel about this, starting the year with a bang?
Yeah, it's been a great 12 months, but I hasten to say part of the circumstances of why it's been tremendous and the interest has peaked is because of the unfortunate situation in Ukraine and the impact on the nuclear fuel supply chain. But nonetheless, the opportunities are there now to replace that Russian supply. And so over the last 12 months in particular, we've seen a lot of interest in the potential construction of new enrichment capacity in the United States. The US government is rolling out some very significant initiatives. The Inflation Reduction Act that was passed through Congress last August carries about $700 million of funding for new enrichment capability to be built in the US. And there are other bills that carry similar packages that are being prepared to be submitted to Congress over the coming term. So a lot of interest from the government, from the White House, through Congress, right down to industry, where we have recently joined forces with some of the nuclear utilities, two letters of interest signed with Constellation and Duke and other utilities, all supporting our subsidiary, our joint venture, Global Laser Enrichment, to complete its efforts to commercialize, because at the moment, the nuclear fuel supply chain is quite vulnerable to that Russian influence, and we have to fix that up for the long term.
Right. Very bittersweet, but we look forward to hearing the updates coming out this year.
Yeah, that's right. We will have some good news flow over the coming year, and we hope that everyone can see the potential of this technology that we invented some time ago in Australia and is now in the hands of Global Laser Enrichment in North Carolina.
Right. Thank you very much for stopping by. Again, the CEO of Silex Systems, Michael Goldsworthy.